stick the cue ball.
Play a nine.
Hello everyone, welcome back to another Tiger Q-tip of the month. And today we've got a really good one. It's playing with follow eye on the cue ball versus playing follow hitting low on the cue ball. So a lot of you are thinking, how is that possible? But it is, and it's very effective. And playing eye on the cue ball with a lot of spin, let's say. So this instance here, I want to try and get shape on the two ball, so I've got to play eye right, but it's impossible to miss the free ball. I will demonstrate it. Where if I play really low on the cue ball with a lot of right spin and just flicking that wrist really loose grip, the white ball just goes forward a lot quicker. You can generate a lot more spin and it really narrows the angle. So I'm going to come off here and back out for the two ball. So basically, this is all about playing with follow, hitting high on the cue ball versus hitting low on the cue ball. So we'll give it a go. Well, firstly, I'm going to demonstrate playing high on the cue ball with as much right spin as possible. So there you go, kiss the two ball. Got very lucky with shape, but obviously more times than not, you're not going to get a result there. So I want to come inside the free ball, so come narrow. So the best way to play this shot, cue ball back on the same spot, is to play very low on the cue ball, loads of right to English, and you're really sort of quitting on the shot and just flicking your wrist as well. Just flick your wrist a little bit and just really, you've got to want the butt of the cue looser than you would normally. So let's give it a go. So loads of bottom right, very loose on the cue ball. And just hit that ball very, very easy, just like that. It just generates that cue ball to go forward a lot quicker. You can generate a lot more spin and it just goes forward a lot quicker. And that's the result. So that eye can come like short of the free ball and come the right way, and that's the result you will get. So it's all about practice, but I prefer to play those type of shots most of the time with bottom compared to top. So that's the difference between playing with follow and bottom, but still getting the white ball to go forward. So it doesn't really, with the physics and the science, you wouldn't think it's possible to get the white ball to go forward playing low on the cue ball. But if you just flick that wrist, just sort of quit on the shot, and it'll be a big shot to have in your locker, and it'll get you out of some tricky situations like this one here. So again, got to have total trust in your tip, and that's why Tiger tips are the best in my opinion. I know exactly what the cue ball is going to do, the deflection, the spin and everything, and that's very important. So hope you enjoyed it, and we will see you next time.